I have a client who uses Phoca download. Hey there, Joomla fans. I'm Tim Davis. Thanks for tuning in again to cybersalt's basic Joomla channel. Today I'm not coming to you from Bogota. I have a client that uses Phoca download, and they asked how they could delete the unwanted files on their server that there are no longer references to inside a Phoca download. It used to be you had to manually find those files through a file manager in your hosting account and manually delete them. But now, with the latest Phoca download and the latest version of Joomla, you can delete those files right while you're managing your references to them in Phoca download. That's what today's tutorial is about. So let's head on over to the computer and check it out. So as I said, this tutorial, we're going to see how to remove unwanted files that you have in Phoca download. Now we're going to do a quick review of how Phoca download points to those files, and we're going to see one setting that you have to change in order for all of this to work. So we're already logged in. I'm already logged in to the basic Joomla site. In the back end, we're at the Phoca download component, components, Phoca download, and we're viewing files. And for this tutorial, I've set up three files. Now, when I say files, think of Phoca download as creating mini documents or articles that point to a file on your server. So you see here, I have one mini document pointing to test file one. It's called test file one. It points to the diet and allergy PDF. I have no idea what's on that file, by the way. It was just on my computer. And I have a test file one copy, which also points to the same PDF. So this file exists on the server once, but there are two files or mini documents pointing to it in Phoca download. And then we have test file two, which points to consultant.pdf. Now, when we click on test file one, we see what you're used to in Phoca download, a title, an alias, category that it's assigned to, and then the file name. And this file name comes from where you have selected it on the server. And what happened before in previous versions of Phoca download was that you had no way to delete these files unless you went in and used the file manager. So we will close that, and we're going to change one setting to enable deleting of files, and then I'll show you what happens when you delete a file that's only occurring once, or that's pointed to only once, and what happens when there's more than one. Now, the first thing, the setting that we want to change, go to Control Panel, Options, and then under the General tab, look for this field here, Delete Existing Files, and change it to Yes. Now, of course, it goes without saying, but I'll say it anyways, make sure you have backup of these files if you're downloading them off your server, but you may want them later on, because this will get rid of them altogether. We've changed this to yes. We'll go save and close. And then we'll go back to files. Now remember, these two test file ones point to diet and allergy, and test file two points to consultant.pdf. And I've logged into my web hosting control panel here and open up the file manager, and we can see the actual folder on the server where those two PDF files are being stored. Now that we've changed that setting, let's go to test file two. First of all, we'll select it by using that checkbox, and we'll click delete. That will change the mini document or mini article that's pointing to that PDF file. It changes it, it deletes it, removes the record to it. And because we changed that setting in order to delete files, we can now go to the file manager. I'm going to reload that folder, and we're going to see if consultant has been removed or not. And yes, it has. Great, that's what we want to do. Now, in Phoca download, you might have a couple of these mini articles or mini pages or whatever you want to call them pointing to the same file as I've set up in this example. And you would hope that if you delete one of these, this file will not be deleted, because that would break its link to the other place that it's pointed to. So as an experiment, let's delete test file one. Delete, go OK, And when we go back to the file manager and reload the page, we see that dietandallergy.pdf is still there. And that's excellent. That means that Phoca download, before it deletes a file, looks to see if it's referenced in any of the other many pages that points to these files. Now we can select test file one copy and delete it. We'll go back to the file manager, we'll reload, and now that page is gone. And this is a huge, huge time saver for people using Phoca download when it comes to organizing and keeping things tidy, because it was too many steps before. So there you go. That's how to delete files using Phoca download from right within Phoca download. I hope that tutorial was helpful for you. And if it was, please give the video a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. Subscribe, ring that bell so you get notifications of new tutorials, and they'll come right to your email. So thanks for watching. Enjoy your Joomla sites. See you next time. Hey there, Joomla fans. Tim Davis here. Thanks again for tuning in. Thanks again.